have to do one more, that is Anupat. The root of us have to start with the pole and end with the zero. So that is the condition that has to be drawn. So you have to start with the pole and end with the zero. That is the thing you have to. And number, how many number of root locus you need to draw? So here, how many number of root locus parts you need to draw, that will be decided by the number of poles. So if your transfer function, if your transfer function is having three poles or two poles, then number of root locus parts will be 2 or 3. So that will be decided by the number of poles. If your transfer function is having 3 poles, means you need to draw 3 root locus part. The root locus part will have to start with the pole and end with the zero. So that is the condition you need to remember. And how many number of root locus part you need to draw is, that will be decided by the number of poles per, depending upon your transfer function. Okay, and you know how to calculate the number of poles. So here, if you are taking an example as, if your transfer function is having g of s, if h of s is equal to, where my h of s is unity feedback system. If your transfer function is unity feedback system, then my h of s value will be equal to 1. So then my transfer function is s into, if your transfer function is having s plus 2 by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. Suppose I am considering this is one of the transfer function. Here my h of s value is 1. Why? Because I am having a unity feedback. My system is here unity feedback. So that was the reason my h of s value is 1. And this one, the transfer function is s plus 2 by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. So to this one, from here we can calculate the zeros, and from here we can calculate the poles. So by seeing this expression, you can easily identify how many number of zeros are there and how many number of poles are there. So here the number of zeros are 1, and here the number of poles are 3. That is, this is equal to 0, this is equal to minus 1 and minus 2. So 3 poles are being present in this transfer function. As 3 poles are being present, you need to draw the root locus parts as 3. So this point you need to remember, and you have to start with the pole and end with the 0. The path what you are drawing in your explain is, you have to start with the pole and end with the 0. That point you need to, these 2 points you need to remember. And here the steps you should be followed by drawing and then by drawing the root locus is, first step is, the root locus is significant to real axis. This thing you need to remember. Means whatever the root locus you are drawing, that should be, it is significant to your real axis. So it should be symmetrical to your real axis part. Then coming to this one, second point is nothing but, you need to identify how many number of poles are there, how many number of zeros are there in your transfer function. That you need to identify. After identifying the number of poles and zeros, you need to locate those poles and zeros in your display. Suppose if you are having a zeros, I am indicating as a Z as 1, and poles I am indicating as a P as 2, you need to mention in your display at which location the zeros are present and at which location the poles are being present. Suppose my 1, 0 is presented in this location, and 2 poles are located in this location, you have to mark with the symbols as zeros and poles. So this is how you need to locate the poles and zeros in your S-plane. Then coming to the fourth point, then you need to sketch the root locus. As I said, the root locus has to be start with the pole and end with the zero. Then you need, according to that one, you need to plot the root locus. So as I said in the previous class, so here if you consider, if you start with the here pole and you have to end with the zero as it. So here from starting itself, here from this point to this point, from this point to this point, this is the root locus, because you started from pole and ending with the zero. If you consider any point in this location, the total number of poles and zeros are odd numbers. In this direction, if you see, odd number. So therefore, the root of the star has been existence. Okay? So this is how you need to draw the root locus. That is your fourth step. Now coming to the fifth step, it has to be existence on earlier axis, as I said. So what are the root locus you are drawing? So that has to be existence on the real axis. That is your fifth step. Then your sixth will be your, we have to know what is an asymptote. So here, what is an asymptote? Here, this is the point. This is the point is you need to draw the asymptote in your SPA. First of all, before drawing, what is an asymptote? So asymptote is nothing but it will guide the root locus from which location, I mean which point to which point the root locus path has to be drawn. That has to be guided with the help of the asymptote. So with the help of asymptote, you can draw the root locus path. Suppose why I am using this asymptote is every time the pole and the root locus will not start with the pole and end with the zero. Sometimes it starts with the pole only, but end with the, it is not end with the zero. So that is what you need to identify. So at that point, you need to take a help, or you need to, this is a guide. This is a guide from which point you need to draw the root locus. So that is the purpose. You need to find out the asymptotes. So here, how many number of asymptotes you need to form? So asymptote is, it just is straight line. You need to draw in an SPA. So that will guide how the root locus has to be drawn. So here, how to find out the number of asymptotes? The number of asymptotes will be calculated by P minus Z. That is nothing but the poles minus zeros. So if your poles is having 3 and zeros, if you are having only 1, then total number of asymptotes you need to draw is 2. Okay? So number of asymptotes means number, how many number of straight lines you need to draw in your S plane means that is number of poles minus number of zeros. So that is, if your transfer function is having a poles as 3 and zeros as 1, then total number of asymptotes you need to draw is 2. So this is how the asymptote to be calculated, and with the help of this asymptote, the root locus path has to be drawn. So that point you need to remember. The next seventh point is you need to calculate the centroid. The centroid, I am indicating with the symbol as sigma. Okay? So here I said that I need to draw the asymptote. So to which point I need to start the, I need to draw the straight line. Okay? That point we call as a centroid. So with the help of this centroid, the asymptote will, we can draw the asymptote. Okay? So the how to calculate this centroid? The centroid will be calculated as number of real part of draw the asymptote. So for that purpose, we need to find out the angle of asymptote. your 2 indicates 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So the 2 value will be where it has 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. We have to start with 2 is equal to 0, then 2 is equal to 1, 2 is equal to 2 and 2 is equal to 3. So according to that you will find out the number of angles. Here how many angles you need to find out is here number of residents. Thank you for the session.